election, you cannot withdraw higher than 500,000. Kaya basig ka ng withdrawal might be used for vote buying. Pero which was speculative. Kaya kung legitimate business, that's normal.
Mm-mm. Are there moves to balikon na?
Wala.
Ah, wala. Okay, I remember you go last election where people were making comments, so much comments
actually,
on that.
Actually, appeal na ang kuan, liquor ban. The last time, isang liquor ban mango, nasa omnibus election code, dapat 2 days ra siya. Mm. On the eve of election and on the day of election. Mm. Then, on the basis sa recommendations sa MMDA, with Tolentino, naingon siya dapat 2 months daw. So, ang COMELEC, somehow, nangita siyang paagi to compromise, gihimo na yung 5 days. But still, wala gisugutan sa Supreme Court. Kaya, klaro man ang balaod nga 2 days ra. So, the COMELEC, sa iyang exercise of quasi-legislative powers, cannot expand the law.
Mm-mm.
So, mo ito nga, it was struck down.
So, 2 days again.
So, mali pa yung mga manginumayan.
And the owner of mga alcoholic establishments.
Exactly, kasi sila yung ibabag na yun. Sila yung neto Supreme Court.
Kay business laws at the other end. Exactly. So, kay isupplement ang laws. So, next is kaning mga policemen and provincial guards na to acting as bodyguards or security guards sa atong mga kandidato. Mm.
So, ginadili po ni sila, no? Unless doon natin mahatag nga certificate of authority sa mga kandidato nga dapat ila po kumbinsiron ang COMELEC nga doon ay real threat against their security.
Mm.
Nga mo na nga pwede sila matagaan ng security detail.
Mm. So, for clarification sa itong viewers, dili tanan mga kandidato na to entitled to a police bodyguard.
Katulang doon ay hulga sa ilang kinabuhi.
Dinhi sa Cebu, na ba tayo hotspot dinhi?
Wala pa tayo gi-identify, no? Pero doon na tayo mga gibantayan ng mga lugar. Kaya ato na silang gitawag karon nga election watch list areas.
Mm-mm.
So, magpaabot pa taon sa final recommendation sa kaning Regional Joint Security Coordinating Council sa COMELEC, AFP and PNP.
Balikan na to, gamay kaning topic sa kaning bodyguards or mga PNP personnel which are assigned as bodyguards sa atong mga political candidates. So, the ultimate authority to determine whether a candidate is given or detailed a PNP bodyguard, it's with the COMELEC.
Yes.
Then subject to the conformity of PNP.
Ano, it's with the recommendation of the PNP. Sa ilang pinaagi sa ilang evaluation sa threat.
Mm-mm.
Kanang gitawag na itong threat assessment.
Mm-mm.
Is the threat real or imaginary? Muna ilang buhat ito.
Dayon, another question, is there a limit to the number of PNP personnel assigned to a candidate?
Yes, so, naagyon. Nindot na kapangutana. No? Na-limit, I think, maximum is 2.
Maximum is 2.
Okay, kuwangan gitag PNP o AFP panahon sa election. So, dapat dili sa muservisyo lang sa pipila ka kandidato, dapat ang servisyo nila para sa tanan.
So it doesn't matter what kind of threat or the amount of threat he receives, 2 ragyod ang maximum. At least maklaro na. Sunod ani is na prohibition sa kaning kinds of public works except so kaning pagtrabaho sa mga dan na to. Dayon, not more than an average na giset din hin ay average number of laborers or employees already employed within the 6-month period. I think mabantayan na to karon mag daghan kayong public works.
Okay. No? Kana gilikayan po na nato kay kani manggood kung doon natay public works nya mo hire tag laborers, no? Pag hire nato laborers, kani mga laborers doon ay pamilya. So ibutan ta lang a family of 5 or 6. So kapag hire nimo, swilduhan nimo, mura na siyang vote buying. Ipalit nimo ang laborer, apili ang pamilya. That's why gilikaya na nga ang atong release disbursement or expenditure of public funds para sa public works ginadili. Except kaning mga ongoing projects, okay, kaning mga under foreign agreements, kana doon na exception. Pero mga igihapon sila authority ikan sa COMELEC.
So it's DPWH or the local government unit nga who has to have clearance or authority from the COMELEC. Kaya maragdaghan manggug kayo o kanang, let's put it at that na lang opinion mga tao. How come all these public works are being rushed or daghan kay gibuhat na lang karon nga ting padung na sa ting pamilyay?
Pero ang prohibited period niya is kuan ha? Mag-start March 25 because that's 45 days prior to election. So, kaning karon okay pa na sila.
Okay pa. Okay, kanisa medyo init-init na topic which is the suspension of elective provincial, city, municipal, or barangay officers.
So, ginadili po na no, ang pag-suspend sa atong local elective officials kay mahimo man siyang instrumento sa kaning nga murag doon na kay mga local elected official nga dili imong kaliado, then imong panimaslan, imong ibalhin, or imong suspenso. So ginadili na siya, subject to exceptions. Number one is mga ikag authority sa COMELEC. Kunya, number two is kung ang suspension niya is for the purpose of implementing the Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act. Mm-hmm. So meaning kung ang ombudsman mo suspend nimo, no need to secure authority from the COMELEC.
Claro na to. Let's say musul siya sa exemption, who suspends the local government official? Is it the LGU or the ALG niya?
It could be the ALG or it could be the Office of the President. Mm-hmm. And so far as kaning mga highly urbanized cities ang concerned, no, mga provinces or the governor can suspend. So kanang dunay mga hungihong like kanang case ni Garcia, yes, nga gi-suspend sa governor. Pwede pa to kay wala pa man sa 45-day period.
Mm-hmm. Are we anticipating some more?
Yeah, dunay mga hungihong, no, nga doon na kunoy mahitabo nga mga suspension, pero so far wala may nadawat nga request for authority.
Mm-hmm. For the benefit of our viewers, kaning murag, because some of them, they think na it's not within murag the bounds pag suspend. They think it's political harassment. Mm-hmm. How should our viewers temper this kanang sentiment na lang? If ilang LG, let's say ang municipal mayor nila na suspend, or some officers sa LGU, how should we temper their sentiment na lang? Because most of the time, especially kung supporters, they think it's harassment.
Well, ang sentiment nato, I think para nako ang pinaka best na opportunity nato to concretize our sentiment is to express it through the ballot.
So maorag yun, what na ilain. So another prohibition here is kaning any person who votes more than once in the same election. So money atong mga flying voters.
Oh, flying voters. Actually, no, listed na lang siya mahitabo karon kay tungod sa atong pag-automate sa elections. Mm-mm. Okay? Natay gitawag nga automated fingerprint identification system nga di na gyud ka pwede ma-double or multiple registrant.
Mm-mm.
Kay nationwide ang database nato mo-merge na siya.
Mm.
So kung pananglit ang imong fingerprints ni appear in two or more jurisdictions, pag merge sa data, masakpan man na double or multiple registrant ka. So, di na ka pwede gilmubutar from one place to another.
So, what will happen, let's say, na detect nila duha imong registration? So, both registrations are cancelled or...
Ang karaan
mo'y mo prevail. Or ang karaan mo'y mawa. Ang karaan mo'y tangtangon. Kani, murag nastoryaan nam yud na to ang kaning biometrics sa atong kuan, sa COMELEC. Napabay kuan karon, napabay taking of
mga wala na gyud even katong petition sa Supreme Court asang Supreme Court
for it to be extended, diba?
Wala na
gyud. So what can our voters expect? So huwat na lang gyud sila after
until that, kung mobalik ang rehistro, dito pa sila makapakwa silang biometrics kung wala pa, or makaparehistro kung wa gyud sila makarehistro.
Isa sad ka topic atong nastoryahan before we started the show is katong prohibition regarding online online campaign. So murag di pam kay familiar atong voters ani. Can you please give us a brief background unsam ning kuan move sa COMELEC for that prohibition?
Ang atong kuan regulation in so far as online campaign propaganda is concerned, doon natay limit, no. Kada website kinahanglan maka publish lang ka diha or maka post ka not exceeding 3 times a week. Okay, per website. Then ang kaning Facebook, which is very popular now, okay, kung pananglit dunay kay mga comment mo, share ka, mo like, mo post, mo comment ka anything about candidates nga mahimo siyang partisan political activity, that's all right because that is part and parcel of freedom of expression, except if you are an employee under the Office of the President, Congress, Judiciary, AFP, PNP, and all those civil service employees, kay mismo ang atong constitution nagdili sa atong gitawag nga partisan political activity.
So pahinumdum niya sa atong viewers nga as set by the civil service na prohibited even if mo like or mo share ka.
Yes.
But I don't think daghan kay nato nga government employees aware ani, because daghan kay sa ila mar they share some very harsh comments.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly, no, kay tingali makalimutan nga dunay prohibition. Hmm. Kay labi na ang atong kuamang good social media, very enticing, ha? Murag kag maagniba nga mo appeal yun. So kinahanglang tingali tag restraint, kay dunay specific nga prohibition. Daghan actually, constitution, local government code, administrative code, civil service act. For as long as you are under the government.
So this is nothing new done by civil service?
Especially public school teachers, no? Kasi sila mo conduct sa voting and counting, they must be partisan at all times, non-partisan at all times.
To your knowledge, was someone ever filed a complaint because of this prohibition?
Yeah, dahan. Daghana.
Ah, daghana. Okay. At least, murag reminder sa ito. Reminder. Kay magdagham kita viewers din yung government employees because they might think it's a simple act of sharing or even liking on Facebook. Diba?
Pero doon naghihapoy pagtugot sa ilan ang ilang participation sa election. Of course, they can vote. Okay? And can they mention the name of the candidates they voted for? Yes. But can they discuss the credentials? No. Because that will be partisan political activity.
Kay very recently, that's how I came to know about that prohibition because someone posted it on Facebook. Me and my friends, actually, we thought it was new, but na-discuss ni mo karon, Marg, na naman di katong mga, there are four regulations which prohibit such. Diba? Then, katong na-mention na to earlier regarding the website, so how does COMELEC regulate or how does COMELEC know these are the official websites of these political candidates?
Okay, kung pananglit owner ka or administrator ka sa website, mandated ka to furnish the COMELEC with a copy of the contract of advertisement placed in your website within 5 days from signing. So, mo na yung atong paagi pag-monitor sa campaign expenses sa mga kandidato.
And can you please explain to us, diba you mentioned there is a prohibition na pag-post 3 times a day ba to?
A week.
A week,
Dapat dili mo lapas. O niya, doon na po siya size limitations, no? Kaning by width or by height sa pixels. Natay gitawang buttons, pop-ups, and skyscraper para sa online propaganda. Na sila yung limit.
Unsam ning skyscraper?
Actually, wasn't good idea, Marge.
I had to ask you because it's my first time nakadungog. Unsam ning skyscraper?
Skyscraper. Basta doon na siya mga limitations, no? Nga, ang width niya, kaninga pixels, doon na pa yung ratio. So, I'm not so techy, so di kayo familiar.
So, monitoring, let's say, ang candidate is from Cebu City. Monitoring is done within the regional office of COMELEC or head office ni?
Pwede sa local offices.
Local offices. So, nana mo yung delegated mga office staff, ano yung more yung ilang trabaho is to monitor?
Wala tayo gi-delegate nga maura yung trabaho. Pero part siya sa daghan kay nga trabaho sa field officers sa COMELEC. That is why we need the help of the public to monitor. And kanig yun, specific yun ang atong mandate sa balaod nga. Required ang website operate of owner or administrator to report to us the contract. Just like TV and radio, mao po lang ilang mandate. Report to us the copy of the contract within 5 days after signing.
But I think TV and radio easier to monitor, di ba?
Actually, mao na yung nahitabo sa kaso ni Governor E.R. Hercito. Kaya di ba na-disqualify siya for exceeding campaign limits? Ang kuwan lagi, evidence lang nga nagpakita nga ni-exceed siya sa campaign limits is ang kontrata niya with ABS-CBN. Kaya he was only allowed around 4.5 million as maximum campaign expense. Pero ang iyong kontrata sa ABS-CBN was 24 million pesos. So how can you deny that?
Sa ABS alone?
Yeah, ABS alone. Napay GMA.
Okay, before we continue, let's take another break. And now we're back. Before our break, istoryahan na to ang mga prohibited acts during election campaign. So before our break, istoryahan to na to katong nahitabo ni Governor E.R. Hercito sa asag itong
Laguna.
Sa Laguna. Nga sa ABS-CBN alone, ABS ba itong?
24 million.
24 million. Then ang allowed nga total is
4.5.
Let's say sila mo submit ang ilang mga contracts. Let's say they have radio ads and ana. Mandated ba ni mga radio stations or mga TV? They're mandated.
Failure to report is an election offense.
Can I have a question, Sad? I think they see this as a loophole ba? Magpakuha sila, endorser sila of a food chain or mag-endorser sila of a pintal ka ng mga hardware. So, ilang mga naong na nasa itong mga billboard, na nasa itong mga TV commercials covered ni?
Actually, dili na allowed. no? Para sa campaign period, oh. Kung doon na kay product endorsement, kinahanglan dili siya ipakita. Doon na decision ng Kamalekani sa Chavez versus Kamalek case, where the Supreme Court said nga kung iato nang i-allow, makahatagtag ang due advantage sa mga celebrities.
Mm-mm.
So dapat during campaign period, kaning mga commercials, mga product endorsements, even movies where you are starring in, or telenovela, panalit artista ka, dili na pwede pagawas.
I think kaning telenovela nga route is being popularly done by candidates. They have their lives depicted, di ba?
But I think prior to campaign period.
Ang
nakabantay ko ni Lenny Robredo sa maalaala mo kaya, that was a week prior to the campaign period. So that was allowed.
Ilasang gitanaw yun nga before campaign period. Kaning, there are talks nga, not to have the Pacquiao fight aired. How is that moving along? Oh, diba nga sa ando daw nga advantage?
Ang gideliberate na sa Commission on Bankaron kay kanila gihapon makahatagtag ang due advantage ni Pacquiao as a senatorial candidate as opposed to uban nga dili boxer.
Mm-mm.
So kung imong i-air live ang iyang the entirety of the fight, so tinood na nga doon na siya due advantage. Pero can media report about it? The answer is yes. Mm-hmm. Freedom of the press and freedom of expression. Mm-hmm. But the issue is, can we air the entire fight? That's another story that is being deliberated upon.
Kanusa ka ni nato mahibaw-an kay murag daghan kay supporters or not even supporters, fancy Manny Pacquiao na who are eager to know whether they can watch him.
Yeah, fight. I think soon dapat before the fight para ma-advise an po si Pacquiao.
Kanina amay kuan gisat din he Kamalek for prohibited contribution, so naay limit as to spending, so kani educational institutions which have received grants for public funds amounting, so kani ang prohibit day kani no contributions for purposes of partisan political activity shall be made directly or indirectly to the following. So ang isa din hing ginadili yun is officials or employees in the civil service or AFP. So na unsa may natay kuan example ani?
Wala tay, you mean specific nga tao? Wala so far, pero kana is actually igura niya gi strengthen ang kaning prohibition against partisan political activity by civil